Good evening, and welcome yet again. Excuse me, band students. And welcome to the 2024 Combined Eastland Roseville Middle School Spring Concert. Thank you all the parents, family, teachers, educators, administrators that are here tonight to support these students. On stage with me now, we have our Combined Eastland Middle School Roseville Middle School Choir, which will be singing four pieces for you with a special treat in between. Up first, we have Fireflies and Someone You Love, and then I'll talk a little bit in between. Sit back and enjoy our performance.
Thank you.
I'd just like to remind that my band students sitting in the front three rows, please remember that you are at a concert. And unlike a rock concert, you are not screaming at the top of your lungs. Please clap appropriately and be respectful, especially during the performance beginning band. Now, at this time, I would like to welcome Megan Brecker to the microphone. Megan is this year's Eastland Middle School Music Student of the Year. Can we go ahead and give her a round of applause? I've had the pleasure of teaching Megan in some capacity for almost all of your middle school career. There's just like those first 3 months in your sixth grade year that I wasn't quite here yet. But I was at Eastland for her sixth grade and seventh grade year, and then I came over to Roseville Middle School this year, and they ended up busing the choir over, so she kept staying with Mr. Hill for her final year. And I honestly couldn't be more proud of her over these past 3 years. She's come so far from when I met her, and I couldn't help but showcase her talent tonight with the rendition of If Only.
My heart, keep playing.
Now, while I have them seated, this makes it easiest. If you are an eighth grader and are getting ready to leave off to high school, would you please stand? To my eighth graders, it has been a pleasure working with you this year, some of you only for one short year, some of you in different capacities over the last several years. I'm very proud of all the hard work that you have put into not only your music, but your own education outside of music, and your ability to just kind of blossom into the people you are meant to be. Thank you so much for being who you are and a part of our ensemble. We will miss you deeply as you go off to high school next year, but we hope to see you at All City Choir and future choir concerts. Thank you, eighth graders. Give them one more round of applause. Now, we have two more pieces left for you, and there are some solos involved in these as well. Our next piece is a popular piece called Ocean Eyes, made famous by Billie Eilish, and I probably said her name wrong, and someone will correct me later, but we have solos by our Juno on alto, we have Amaya over here on soprano, and we also have Savannah on a soprano solo. So we have several soloists. Please wait to clap until the end of the piece, just so we don't interfere with the performance. And I will come up and talk a little bit about the last one before we begin. Sit back and enjoy Ocean Eye. This is probably, was that your first time doing solos, all three of you, yeah? Is that your first time singing in front of everybody all on your own? Yeah, that's pretty impressive, isn't it? Can you give those three solos one more round of applause? I know I wasn't too eager to do that when I was their age. It was definitely not my strong suit performing in front of people, and it still isn't. So I'm very proud of them for that. Now our final piece is the only one that, actually, I'm sorry, this one does rhyme. I had an almost whole rhyming concert, you know, fireflies, ocean eyes, blue skies. someone you love kind of broke that. Up next and last is our piece called Blue Skies. This one's gonna kind of change the entire feel. We've been kind of nice and relaxed. We're gonna jazz it up a little bit at the end. We have two more soloists on this piece. We're gonna have Lyric on a scat solo. We're also gonna have Raven Watley on a scat solo. So go ahead and listen to those. And again, please refrain from clapping until the end. My students, so you think you can snap, please try to contain. We're going to snap. We're not going to snap the whole time through. I don't want you to throw them off, okay? So sit back, relax, enjoy the choir's final piece, Blue Sky. Combined beginning band. This is a range of 6th through 8th grade students that are in their first year, or maybe they did something in 5th grade band that they weren't necessarily in love with, and then they decided, well, I'm gonna change my instrument and I wanna try something again. Or even in 6th grade, maybe they played trumpet and they wanted to play saxophone, so they switched again. This is just kind of the first year on their instrument group, and this is combined two different hours. This is first and second hour of the day, so they kind of only got them to do this together twice. So it's a little crazy, but we're gonna make it work. They're definitely capable. So I'm gonna have very little talking for the rest of the concert. I'm gonna allow my students to do the brunt of the work. So I'm gonna invite Addison to come up and introduce our first piece.
Majestic theme and powerful rhythms. It feels like you're preparing for battle. Join us for a thrilling musical journey that captures the spirit of knights and epic adventures.
Thank you. Aftershock by Larry Clark is a moving piece that explores resilience after a challenging event. Though it's expressive music, it takes listeners on a journey from uncertainty to hope, showcasing the strength of the human spirit. Experience a heartfelt musical portrayal of overcoming adversity with Aftershock.
From the opening fanfare to lively melodies, it captures the excitement of life on the high seas and highlights of our percussion section. Join us for an unforgettable journey through the world of Blackbeard.
Thank you.
John Edmondson is an exciting musical journey filled with pulsating rhythms and vibrant melodies. Inspired by the energy of dance, this dynamic composition invites listeners to join in a celebration of life and movement. We hope you enjoy our performance of Fire Dance.
Brings to life an ancient Roman poetry collection sharing the same name from the first century AD. The poems deal with early astronomy, most notably the 12 signs of the zodiac. The piece begins with a slow, mysterious opening, then increases tempo and layers several melodies to depict the wonders of the stars. Join us in honoring the stars through our performance in Astronomica.
band is a kind of, again, 6th, 7th, and 8th grade level course, which is kind of your first, if you were doing really good in 5th grade, maybe your second year on your instrument, maybe your third, kind of all that happy medium. And it meets every day during 3rd hour, which is right after lunch. So it's very fun in the band room. Never a sticky key, I promise. Okay. Now, we have one more piece for you today, which again, I will have a student introduce, but I just wanted to give a little shout out to Logan. He did have a little timpani solo, and he's not going to know that I was going to call him out, but one little round of applause for Logan over there on the timpani. And then, I don't believe I have many, but could my eighth graders please stand? Yeah, I know. You didn't want to be called out. Up, 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 up. Stay standing. I just want to talk about you for a second. These guys have been a real, real big help with these younger musicians that are up on stage with you. Mr. Lewis over here on the flute has been absolutely crushing it. You're going to hear him a little bit in this next piece with the flute section future. He's a marvelous flute player, a marvelous young man, and I'm very happy to have him in my ensemble. And then we have Torrance back there on the trumpet, who is doing an exceptional job this year, kind of taking charge of the trumpet section. It's always a pleasure to have you in my classroom. I will greatly miss you both as you go off to high school, and thank you for being a part of our band. Go ahead and have a seat, guys. One more round of applause for those two. I'm not reading it. Thank you.
Hi, I'm Vila Watson, and our final piece this evening is Ironclad by Sean O'Loughlin. This exciting piece is inspired by the strong iron-plated ships of the 19th century. In Ironclad, you'll hear powerful music that captures the strength and adventure of these ships. Imagine an ironclad cutting through the waves, ready for anything. Sean O'Loughlin is known for his engaging music that tells stories and evokes vivid images. We hope you enjoy Ironclad and feel transported to a time when these mighty ships rule the seas.
Chloe Mullen. She's an alto saxophone player. If you don't know me, I also play the saxophone, so it's kind of my favorite. All right. Now, she's been working hard. She's been really gung-ho about just kind of playing all year. She most recently was in the morning announcements doing the Star Spangled Banner, right? Yeah, so she's been playing quite a bit outside of band. Okay, and today she's going to just play for you a little ditty that you'll probably recognize. I won't even need to say the name. Please go ahead and listen to Chloe Mullen playing some alto saxophone for you. Thank you for staying with us. It's probably the longest concert I've had in my 5 years around kind of doing this whole thing. So thank you. I know it's hot in here. I appreciate you staying. We'll make this as quick as possible. Now, I'm going to introduce, I want to say, Zay, to come up and introduce our first piece. So come on up, Zay.
Afterburn by Randall Stanbridge is an exciting composition filled with energy and intensity, using strong rhythm, lively percussion, and bold brass sections. The piece creates a thrilling experience reminiscent of flying or speeding throughout space. We hope you enjoy your performance of Afterburn, our performance.
Thank you. trumpet soloist Kennedy Fitzsimmons invites listeners to enjoy a captivating music journey inspired by the beauty of the moonlight night. By contrasting gentle melodies with an upbeat rhythm pattern. By the piece depicts an adventure by the light of the moon.
There's still a week left of school. You're going to have to listen to me more tomorrow, okay? But could my eighth grade, I know. Could my eighth graders please stand? And could my entire percussion section just kind of fan out, being that you're, all eighth graders, and I don't know what I'm going to do without you next year. Eighth graders, please stand. How about a round of applause for the eighth graders of Roseville Middle School Advance Band? Please stay standing for just a second. Now, when I got here, you are the group that's had quite the journey. Yeah? How many band directors have you had? Count on your fingers. 1, 2, 3. And now let's add your fifth grade band director, too. 4. Thank you. That about sums up those 3 years for you. So, it's been a journey for them. Some of them have had, you know, most of them have had 3 different band directors in 3 years. And that makes it really hard to learn your instrument. You're constantly learning a new person, constantly adapting to a new system. It's tough. But they're fearless. So fearless, in fact, that they got over the mean old Mr. Hill thing really quickly. It took a little bit of tough love, but we got everything together. And they became probably one of my favorite parts of every day, without fail. That's you eighth graders. And while at it, they also, everybody in this ensemble, received a Division I rating at MSBOA District Band and Orchestra Festival for the first time in 12 years. And while the seventh grade had so much to do with it, it wouldn't have been possible without our eighth grade leaders forging the way, showing that we have grit, showing that we can persevere, and showing that we belong in the conversation of a quality band. And you are just that. And it is so sad to see all of you go, even if some of you are only there once in a blue moon, and every 6 hours you suddenly, boop, disappear. I don't want you to disappear forever, okay? Thank you for being my first eighth grade class here at Roseville Middle School. It's been an absolute honor and a privilege. Thank you so much, and good luck in all that you do. Now, I talked about that eighth grader of the year award, and I know Mr. Gelsoni might get mad at me because I'm pretty sure I'm not supposed to say anything until tomorrow, but he said go ahead, so I'm gonna do it. Now, Daryl, could you please stand for a moment? I wanted to save this to where it was just Roseville. Daryl is actually our 8th grade choir student of the year. So go ahead and give Daryl a round of applause. I'll let him sit down. I understand. When I first met Daryl, I actually didn't teach him. I just was here as a spectator at a concert. And he's heard this story before and he hates when I tell it. But he had a little solo at a winter concert, and what was it? I'm Mr. Nice Christmas, I'm Mr. Huh? Sound familiar? But this man, were you seventh grade? Was it last year? Seventh grade? Yeah, as a seventh grader, came up here on the stage by himself at the choir behind him and just owned it. Did a little shoulder shimmy and everything that I was just hardly brave enough to do. And sold it. He's a fantastic vocalist, a fantastic young man. He has a bright future if he keeps on the right path. And I'm so happy to have had you this year as my own choir student. And I will miss you, and I hope you continue with Miss Mead in high school. One more round of applause for Daryl. And could Alyssa Sherman please stand? Alyssa Sherman is our eighth grade band student of the year. Could we give a round of applause for Alyssa? Alyssa is the embodiment of a model student. She is the standard, if not the exceptional version of it. Every day, always with a smile on her face, in her own little way. I think I have several images littered all over my whiteboard that you have drawn with Taryn and several of your friends. Some of them scare me. Some of them are just different versions of me as, like, I don't know. What did you draw me as? A snake. Mr. Hill as a snake. Mr. Hill as a donut. Mr. Hill as eighth notes. Yes. They've made several different versions of Mr. Hill, and they still stay on the board. Okay. But outside of the creativity and the excellence of student just kind of behavior, she's also kind of fearless in her own way. Alyssa was one of our three students that went to MSBOA State, or not State, District Solo and Ensemble, which is, I think, the first time we sent, maybe we sent one person last year. Okay, we haven't really sent a whole lot of people. And she went for the first time and performed a solo and a duet with Taryn and received two first division ratings at District Solo and Ensemble. And then there's this thing called the District MSBOA District 16 Honor Band, where two students from each school in the area are chosen based on merit and ability. And Alyssa was one of our students that was chosen for the 8th grade Honor Band, which was fantastic. And then also, just to give a little shout out to Sophia Dye, she was our other student at Honor Band with her. But Alyssa was fearless. And she had quite the journey at Honor Band. The music was not easy. I'm pretty sure you thought it was going to be way more chill than that. You thought Mr. Hill threw stuff at you. Woohoo! Rhythm standard, right? But she came through, she persevered, and she did it with a smile. She was fearless, and I still have that little picture that we took at the end where you're doing your crazy little pose, and I'm just sitting there like, because that's me. She's the personality. She has it in her. She's a fantastic student. I couldn't be happier with how she's done this year, and I'm so happy to see what you continue to do in Roseville in the future. Thank you, everybody. Alyssa Sherman. And now, to put the mic down, here's Daryl to introduce our final piece. Thank you again to all of you for being here today, teachers, administrators, parents, friends, family, students. I couldn't do my job without all of you. It is a blessing to be in Roseville. I'm so happy to finally be home. And I promise you, I'll be here for a long time to come, as long as you have me. Thank you. Here's Daryl.
Seconds Out is by Samuel Hazel. It's a dynamic composition that takes listener on an exciting musical journey. With the pulsating rhymes, powerful brass fanfares, and driving percussion, the piece captured the energy of championship boxing match. Hazel used his instrumentation is sure to keep you on the edge of your seat from the start to finish. Thank you for supporting the Roseville Middle School Department. We hope you enjoy Seconds Out.